Welcome, folks, to tonight's game. This one promises to be a good one between the NC State Wolfpack and the North Carolina Tar Heels. Number 50 is an unbelievable player who's been given the reins to take his team to victory.
This is why he frustrates his opponents. You can't leave him open on offense because he's a great shooter. Then on defense, it's hard to score against him because he's a great defender.
The Tar Heels will certainly want to take advantage of his presence on the floor. The Wolfpack get control of their possession, and we get going. The Tar Heels should be looking at a tough fight tonight, Dick. What have they got to do to win this thing?
They've got to stick to their game plan and focus on these keys. Number one, pound the ball inside. Challenge their big men. Secondly, you got to pound the board. Boards lead to wins, baby. And lastly, play every defensive possession like it's the last.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us. Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing off is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Both teams looking to get things going here. They look to get it to the inside. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Trying to draw the foul. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. He launches a three. Way off target. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. In the paint. For two. Basket falls despite the contact.
Trying to go inside.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Here's a double team. Number four fakes the shot. Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Great job of freeing himself with the screen, but shot won't go.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. He gets the rejection. Dumps it in. Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
Trying to feed inside. They work the perimeter. Lawson receives the pass. From three-point range. Off the rim and no good. Number 12 handles the feed. Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. He buries it.
That's a 7-0 run.
For the bucket, and in and out. On the outside, Grant receives the ball. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
They've got a player spotting up on the three. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
And the ball goes out of play. Lawson handles the pass. He tries the three ball. Way off target.
Look at that spacing.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box. High post screen. So effective, that screen.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
On the outside, he's got an open look for the shot. Nope, he got the dunk and the foul.
He went through that lane on a mission, Brad.
He is going to the line. Gets it. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
He's got a high post flasher. Attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Tries for two, and he missed. Looking for a good shot. Jumps into the defender. Drops the bucket despite the harm. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip. Going one way, and you spin back the other way.
Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Goes up for two. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated. I sometimes wonder what it would be like to be a Skywalker, elevating and throwing it down, Mr. Nessler. How much fun would that be? Block shot usually creates momentum and opportunities.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Gave it up. He fires from long range. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
He's doing a nice job defensively fronting it.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
Off the rim and no good. They work it around the perimeter. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Dick, if you ask me, they're not getting a whole lot of open looks tonight.
They're not moving the ball the way they were taught, Brad.
Dick, he's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
And he'll kick it back outside. He attempts the trifecta. 10 on the shot clock. Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop.
For that reason right there, that's why I love college basketball.
The Rutgers fans are going nuts. They're going bananas, Brad.
Goes up for two. He puts it in with contact and all. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
There's the pick. There's the roll. For two. Drains the shot. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad and Dick, there is a sense of concern on the bench right now. The coaching staff fears if the other players don't get involved soon, it may be too late. He keeps stressing to his team, I can't do this by myself, so help me out. We'll have to continue to monitor this one, guys, along the way.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Tell me this ain't the play of the night, Brad.
The Tar Heels find themselves quite high in the ESPN polls. I don't think they can afford to relax, though.
That's the price you pay for being at the top, Brad.
Looking for a good shot.
Up and inside.
There's the fake. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Thinks about the shot. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He gets another one to go.
This is a shooting clinic, my friend.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Working it around the perimeter. The Wolfpacks have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a...
Basket's good and the foul.
That's a big play. He was there when they needed him, baby.
He's mocking the crowd. Now that's throwing salt on the wound. The fans are definitely going to be annoyed with him.
Man, the players are feeling it, and they want everyone to know that they're feeling it.
Hickson steps to the line for the first time. Makes it. Both teams looking to get things going here. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The ball goes out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
And it's good. That wide stance and the drop step.
I tell you, it's all about angles, and if you utilize that drop step, it's like a reverse pivot move.
On the outside. He shoots from the low post.
Wow, used the screen perfectly, but the shot didn't go.
Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch. Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
He takes the shot off the baseline. Now they work it around the perimeter. Trying to draw some contact. Makes it.
Tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
He attempts a jump hook. They still don't score. There's a bad pass right to the defender. They'll work it around the arc. Up fake. Jumps in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Dick, he's going to go up strong.
Oh, that's a terrific post play. Didn't waste any time attacking the basket.
The skip pass is picked off.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
Yeah, they really know how to show their appreciation for him.
From three-point territory.
Screen was there, but the shot didn't fall.
Looking for a good shot. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
And he'll kick it back outside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He throws it up from downtown. Way off target. This zone is working miracles on defense tonight, Dick.
Hey, they've been active and they're taking everything away.
Here's a spin down to the low block. And one. Are you kidding me?
Hey, he threw that down with authority, baby. Make a statement, young man. Make a statement.
At the line. He sinks it.
A lot of pressure on a basketball. Way to play the ball. Tough. Drive him, beat him, turn him, beat him to his spot.
And the ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Dribble, gives it up, and he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip, going one way, and you spin back the other way.
On the outside. He pulls the trigger. The Wolfpack to find a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Brady's on fire.
Front fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Fakes the shot. Puts it on the floor and up and under. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
The Tar Heels have a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
Big man spins down on the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other.
He'll go to the line. It's good. That opportunity either.
Defense extending the old game law. Is that pressure on the ball?
He strips him clean.
And a slam.
Poor judgment results in a backcourt violation.
You got to take care of the rock, baby.
Ball coming in from the sideline. Working it around the perimeter. And now with a power move on the inside.
Did a great job protecting the basketball, seals the defense off, and explodes to the basket.
They're going to call this one a backcourt violation, Dick.
You can't make mistakes like that too often, Brad.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Blocked! Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Makes a move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul there.
He's out of control, baby, out of control.
That's a great defensive effort being all over the ball. They get the 5-second call. They're set to throw it in from the side. Gave it up. Puts it up, looking for contact. North Carolina is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now. Dump it inside.
On the dribble, gives it up for two. Goes.
Let's get a replay, baby.
Moving it around the perimeter. Takes the pass in the paint. He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
Whistle blown. That's a backcourt infraction.
You can't make those kind of mistakes in games like these, Brad.
So they'll inbound on the near sideline. He got fouled and the bucket.
He took it about himself, Brad. Big play, big time scoring.
Number 23 sees his first action of the day.
Man, I love to watch this kid play, Brad. He's the type of player who knows how to really lift the team.
Rims out.
Brad, if they were smart, they'd go 2-for-1.
Good fake. He goes with a jump hook.
I'll tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting the good inside angle, a poor job defensively, no help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Tries for two.
I love the skyhook, especially when you get great post position on the interior.
At the half, the Wolfpack are ahead by eight. We've had a very tight contest tonight, Dick. What's your highlight of the half?
My highlight of the half has to be this high-flying slam jam, baby. He went up like he wanted to tear the rim down on this one.
All right, Dick, let's get back to the action as the two teams are just about ready to start the second half. North Carolina couldn't retrieve the rock if their life depended on it right now, Dick.
Brad, what they've done is allowing the opposition to get second shot opportunities, and that usually leads to a disaster.
Start of the second half, Dick, our focus player update. What's he got to get done in the second half for them to win?
I would run him off screens on the right and left. I would set up screens and have him pop out to shoot that trifecta.
This young man means so much to this team, and the fans just love him.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level. I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the coaching staff knew this would be a key heading into tonight's matchup. This is something they stressed during pregame, and it's something they're talking about on the benches right now. The message, get the ball inside. Guys, they're doing that.
Thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you one thing, you better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action.
Down in the low block, trying to work the lane. And he scores despite the hack. The dunk and one.
Great job of going up strong and through the contact, baby.
With the free one. He hits it. The Wolfpack lead by 11. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He uses the shot fake. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
On the outside, ball handler's in trouble. And a momentary look from three-point land. Lawson draws the personal. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
He goes to the line for the first time. First shot is good.
Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
High post flashes for the opportunity. Takes the pass in the paint. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Doesn't go. And And he'll kick it back outside. He unloads. He drains it.
Let's see if the replay does that any justice. He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
For two, easy one.
That one's definitely worth a second look, Brad.
For the bucket, up, easy one. The Wolfpack are ahead by five. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. On the dribble, gives it up. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
He fires it up. Off the rim and no good.
That's one of the things I absolutely love about college basketball, Dick, the atmosphere.
Wow, the energy is unbelievable in here.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
At the free throw line. First one is good. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Both free throws go. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Time to pick up the defense here now. A whistle and foul. The coach not happy on the sideline. The post flashes up high if he wants it. Goes up for two. He forces another bad shot.
That is not how you win ball games, Mr. Nestler.
For two, and in and out. Number 12's lowly performance has just gotten in his head.
Brad, he's in what many people call a funk. Emotionally, he's got to turn things around.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
There they come with a double team to stop it. Pull-up jumper from way out. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game. Dump it inside.
Has a nice look at the basket. For the bucket. They still don't score. In the paint. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He tries a jump hook. Can't get the shot to go. They work the perimeter. Tries for two, in and out. Goes up for two, perfectly executed. For two, and off the mark.
High post screen, gonna use it. Great play to take that to the basket. Up it inside.
Entry pass in the paint. Knocks it down.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Picked out of the air. The Smith Center is in complete chaos at the moment. Number 50 is fired up and ready to go.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
For the bucket, they still don't score. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Doesn't go. And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that
shot. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
The ball goes out of play. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Gave it up. Fakes a jumper. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He puts in another score.
He can see the light, Brad, and it's hanging right over the goal.
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. In and out. They move it into the front court.
He did a great job recognizing the double team.
Moving it around the perimeter. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Number 32 makes his first appearance.
I tell you, this youngster can provide a spark on either side of the floor, Brad.
First shot, good. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, he seemed very focused from the beginning. His game face was on, and he understands it's his time to perform. Let's send it back over to you.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Gave it up. In the paint, looking for contact.
Got to make that, baby. Had that wide open angle. Had a chance to lay it on the glass for an easy deuce.
On the dribble, gives it up with a deep shot from outside. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Went away from the post and goes the other way. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Looking for a good shot. Gave it up. Takes the pass in the paint. The lay-in. The Smith Center is in complete chaos at the moment. In the paint. He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Now they work it around the perimeter. With a rejection.
That was Intimidation City.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive.
Scores it, and he's fouled. So an and one opportunity here.
The momentum is on their side. High fives, chest bumps. We're seeing it all now.
Hey, can you blame them, Rod? They're playing well.
Foul shot is not good. And he'll kick it back outside. Fakes it. Number 33 is called for the defensive foul.
Look at him, Dick. He's trying to pump up the crowd. He and his team have made a series of great plays, and boy, do they have the momentum now.
Pump them up, young man. Pump them up.
Number one subs back in.
Hey, that little breather may just have been what the doctor ordered.
Is that how they say it, that saying, Brad?
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He puts up the three ball. Way off target. Looking for a good shot. On the inside, looking for the foul.
Step out of that screener.
Top of the circle. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Tries to get the D to bite. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Can't get the shot to go. Tries for two. They still don't score.
Spacing.
He strokes it off the rim and no good. Number 12.
His modest performance is bringing down his confidence level.
Brad, I see a young man who's struggling at both ends of the court.
Got a nice screen. The friendly bounces aren't going their way at the moment, Dick.
They need to get some easier looks, Brad.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job of post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Basket falls despite the contact. Power forward gets the pass.
Run him right into the screen again. What did I say?
He unloads a three. Buried it. On the dribble, gives it up. That's good.
That's worth another look.
Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off. I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Nice drop step.
I tell you, he does a great job with his footwork to create the drop step.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Using his size with a power move.
Oh, what a power goal. Jump stop, takes the ball with a goal, strong.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper, in and out. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. Unloads a three. Rims out. On the outside, pump fakes. He shoots from right of the circle.
Hey, kept his dribble. Screen was there, but he couldn't get the shot to drop.
Outside jumper. Nice shot. The student body is rocking tonight. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
He hits it. This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Ellington receives the pass.
That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
He throws up the shot. Off the rim and no good. With a stop here, there will be sheer pandemonium in the stand. They'll work it around the arc. For the deuce. Drops the bucket despite the harm. I'll tell you what, with a score, this crowd is going to go nuts, Dick. Looking for a good shot. Takes the pass in the paint. He puts it in with contact and all. The Tar Heels will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. Cross court. Picks off the pass. Here's a spin down in the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and now the spin move to the goal.
The lead is five. What happens now, Dick?
Well, this is where momentum can swing in your favor or go against you enough to blow your game.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. And he hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end.
Mr. Excitement with that jam.
Floor. 7 points right now is the difference in this one.
Hey, Brad, 7 points is no safe haven. You got to keep pressing.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got him in the face-up position in the post.
Ellington handles the pass. And the ball goes out of play.
Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
The lead is now 7 points.
This game is still up for grabs, Brad.
The Smith Center is in complete chaos at the moment.
Well, Dick, what's the front court production looking like to you?
Well, you know, Brad, your bigs really can influence how your teams play. Rebound, blocking shots, altering shots are all very important skills which your big players should possess.
As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Makes the second.
They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
We'll get back to the action here after the timeout. Goes up for two. He is just lighting it up, Dick.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
Well, Mr. Vitale, there's the foul situation so far.
Hey, Brad, staying out of foul trouble down the stretch of any game is vital. You want to keep your opponents off the free throw line and out of bonus situations.
Makes the front end of the 1-1. Makes the second shot.
No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
He attempts the three. He hits the shot.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
And we'll go to the free throw line. He missed it.
A basket here will make this a two-possession game.
Looking for a good shot. Number 5 is asking the fans for even more encouragement.
He wants the crowd up and out of their seats for the next possession.
Perimeter. They work it around the perimeter.
Our focus player update, our final one of the ball game, and he led his team to victory.
Well, I'll tell you, 9 out of 10 times, if the focus player plays well, you're going to get to the winner's circle.
North Carolina wins the game.
Well, they may have come in a little overconfident, but they held their composure at the end.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.